Hey and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. We have 10 noteworthy updates for you this month. Let's start with Site Explorer. We've added a calendar view to Page Inspect that shows you the history of page changes over time. The darker the color, the more content changes were made on a page that day. For example, this square on January 8 is a deep green. And if I click it, you can see the exact things that have changed on this page. In this case, a huge content update. Note that how far back in time you can see here depends on your Ahrefs plan's limits. Moving on, we've added two new use cases in the opportunities report, potential cannibalization and descriptive anchors. The potential cannibalization opportunity helps you to spot cannibalization issues, so you can consider consolidating pages that may be targeting the same page. And the descriptive anchors opportunity helps you to spot instances where you can replace generic anchors like read more, click here, etc., with more descriptive ones. Moving on, you might be familiar with the lowest DR filter in Keywords Explorer that lets you filter through high difficulty keywords where a low DR website ranks at the top. We've now added that to the organic keywords report inside Explorer as well. This should make it easier to spot opportunities where you can rank with a low DR website. Moving on to Keywords Explorer, you can now use checkboxes to select up to 10,000 keywords. Your selection is kept when you switch pages or sort by any metric, but will reset if you apply any filters. From here, you can add your selected keywords to a list or project or mass update SERPs for them. Moving on, you can now cluster common keyword ideas by parent topic for Brunei, Hong Kong, Japan, Korea, Taiwan, Trinidad and Tobago, and Vietnam. Moving on to one cross-tool update. When comparing SERPs inside Explorer, Keywords Explorer, and Rank Tracker, you can now see the actual text of a featured snippet and compare how it changed over time. This should give you more context when analyzing SERPs so that you can optimize your content more efficiently. Moving on to Site Audit. Before, you could only compare a crawl with the one before it. Now, you can select any two crawls for comparison. For example, now I can compare issues for a recent crawl to a crawl back in January. I can sort by organic traffic changes to quickly find pages with significant traffic drops during this time, or track how we've been dealing with technical issues on our site since then. Moving on to Rank Tracker. We've added a lot of new widgets to the GSC overview report, like top keywords, top keyword changes, low-hanging fruit keywords, which shows you the most popular keywords where your target's ranking position is between 4 and 15, potential cannibalization, which shows you keywords with multiple ranking URLs, and top pages and top page changes. Moving on, in the Pages 2.0 report, you can now click to open nested keyword tables, which show you all the keywords your target is ranking for. Moving on to our general updates. We've just released our first Rank Tracker API V3 endpoint for Overview 2.0. As always, you can use the API button in the report itself to create request URLs for filters you've applied. Requests to this endpoint are free and do not consume units. I'll leave a link to the API documentation below. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Canny. See you in the next update and have a great day.